Hello, boys and girls. I'm Superintendent John Barry, and I want you to know that I'm really proud of the great things you have done this past year. Now, many of you took the CSAP test last year, and you did great. And I look forward to all of you continue to improve on your scores every year. So it'll be soon for you to be able to take the CSAP test again. And the test you start taking in the third grade, and you take it all the way up to the 10th grade. And CSAP helps your school and your teachers to see what you need help on in reading, writing, math, and science. So you may be wondering why you take the CSAP. It's just one way to show your teachers, your parents, and really the entire state of Colorado how much you've learned this year. And based on how you do on CSAP, your teachers next year will be better prepared to be able to help you as you go on to bigger and better subjects. The CSAP test also helps you become a better thinker and a better writer, and both of these skills are very important to you as you grow older. So what can you do to get ready to take the CSAP? Well, if you've been doing well in school, staying focused, and doing all your assignments and homework, then you're already halfway there. CSAP tests you on what you've learned so far this year. And here are some other things I'd like you to think about to be able to prepare you for taking the CSAP. First, be sure to get plenty of rest each night before your test. Maybe go to bed an hour earlier than you usually do. I know you don't necessarily want to do that, but it's an idea that I'd like you to think about. Be sure to eat a good breakfast in the morning before each test. This will give your body and your brain the fuel you'll need to do well on the CSAP test. Do your best on each and every question. Now, some of the questions will be very easy for you to answer. Other questions will challenge you to think deeper and stretch your brain. Concentrate and answer each question as best you can. Now, if you get stuck on any one question, go on to the next question and then come back to that question after you have answered all the others. And now, let's hear from some of your fellow students on how they're getting ready to take the CSAP test.
The things I do that help me get ready for CSAP are eat a healthy breakfast, I study the night before, and I try to relax.
Well, when I'm taking the test, the CSAP tests are timed, so if there's ever a question I get stuck on, I just skip it and come back to it.
Well, to get ready, what I do is I go to bed early at night, because like if you go to bed late, you'll get tired and you'll only be thinking of how sleepy you are. And I also like eat breakfast, like not just a small breakfast, but I eat like cereal with some juice or something.
Some of the things that I do to get ready for CSAP are I read my textbooks, like I read textbooks, questions, answer them so that I can get prepared for the test. I do like independent work, and we have fluency workbooks at my school, so I work on those, and those help me solve problems and get prepared for CSAP.
Remember, this is your chance to shine, and I believe in you. I believe that you are all great students, and I believe that we have great teachers and staff members who care about you and what you want to do to be successful. So let's show everyone in Colorado that we're the best school district with the best students in the entire state. If we all work together, I believe we can reach our vision of giving every one of you the chance and the choice to attend college, because we always talk about going to college. Whenever I ask the question, how many students are going to college, I always have everyone raise their hand. But I need your help, and I need to count on your ability to do the best you can on the CSAP in all of your classes. Thank you, boys and girls, and good luck.